Okay, well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Department of Chemistry. This lecture, then, we are looking at Group 1 of the periodic table. Now, of course, everything around us is made up of the elements, and there are many elements, so here are a few elements. So we have, for instance, there's oxygen, of course, aluminium, calcium, all these are common elements, carbon, nitrogen. But there are many, many elements. We're going to be here quite some time at this rate. There's over 100 different elements. Here they all are in some rather random order. Remember, these make up everything around us in some form or another. How can we make sense of all these elements? Well, the first person that did this, that actually made some sense of the different elements, was this chap, Dmitri Mendeleev, a Russian. And he first proposed the periodic table of the elements. And this is our starting point for today. We're going to be looking at one family of elements within the periodic table, or a group. We're going to be looking at group one. Now, this is the red group colored here, maybe hydrogen at the start, then lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, and cesium. So Mendeleev arranged all the elements in order of, well, he arranged them in order of increasing atomic weight. That's not quite how it should be, but that's not quite the real point of the periodic table, as we shall see shortly. But he also, this was his key stroke of genius, arranged them into groups with related properties. And the groups are shown vertically like this. So this is group one, we have group two here, another family with similar properties, group three, or 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. These ones are the noble gases, for instance, all of these are gases. So within each group, they have similar properties. We sort of skipped over these ones in the middle. These are called the transition metals. Okay, so these include things like iron, copper, nickel, and so on. These are common metals. They're in the transition metals. And we also glossed over these ones down the bottom there. They're sort of squeezed in where you see those flashing symbols. This would make the periodic table far too long, so usually they're cut out and put at the bottom instead. But we're going to focus on group one. Here they are, group one. Now, what do they have in common? This is the important point. What do all these things have in common? Well, to understand this, we need to look at the atomic structure. So, let's start off with the first atom, hydrogen. So, hydrogen consists of a proton, and the proton is coloured red here. The proton has a positive charge, and this is balanced by the same number of electrons. The electrons are shown in yellow. So the electron is whizzing around the nucleus. The nucleus is made up of protons and neutrons. The hydrogen atom, though, doesn't usually have any neutrons. The number of neutrons varies. Neutrons have no charge, but we can have different numbers in the same sort of atoms. So we're really interested in the number of protons and electrons. Now, as we move across the periodic table, from one element to the next, the number of electrons and protons increases by one. We add one extra proton, positive charge, in the nucleus, and one extra electron to keep it neutral. So here are, this is helium. We've got one extra electron. Now, the next key point is that we start adding electrons into different shells. So for the next element, lithium, with three electrons in total, it has just one electron in its outermost shell, moving around, as you see, moving around right around the far away from the central nucleus. But then we move across again, we add an extra proton, an extra electron, so beryllium here in group two has two electrons in its outermost shell. Boron has three electrons in its outermost shell. Carbon here has four. Nitrogen has five electrons. Oxygen has six electrons in its outermost shell. Fluorine has seven electrons in its outermost shell. There's two in the middle as well, so there's nine in total, but seven in the outermost shell. Neon has eight in the outermost shell, and that's full up now. So now the next electron that we have to add goes into a new shell, and this is where we get back to sodium, the next one in group one.